Hey guys, welcome to Nighthawk Gliders. I'm Brad. Today we're going to build some toothpick gliders. In this case, a biplane. This is a pretty cool plane and you will be amazed at how well it flies. The materials that you will need are going to be 3x5 cards, typical note cards. You can choose various colors. You might find fluorescent. And the ones that you want to get are those that are lined, that have a rule, such as this. I also found some other colors. These are more muted. We have a blue, kind of a dark yellow, red, and yellow. But what's cool about these is that they have different colors on the back. So it kind of give you a bit of variety on how you want your wings to look. So we could do red and blue, or dark yellow and orange, or kind of a sea green and purple. Pretty cool. So I think today we're going to make this plane yellow and pink. Some other materials that you will need: a ruler, a knife, pencil, pliers. Seems a little weird, but I'll show you a little bit later why we use pliers. Some glue on some wax paper. Just a little dollop of glue there. Some modeling clay, or perhaps blue tack, or anything else that you might have, sticky for ballast. And that's pretty much it. So how to make this glider is, first off, the rules on this card are 1/4 inch each, which is nice because our wing cord is 1/2 inch, so we can easily use these lines for measurement. So first off, I'm just going to go ahead and cut off the top unused portion of this. And then I'm going to measure out 2.5 inches. This is going to be my wingspan. We'll need a couple wings since it is a biplane. There we go, put that aside for now. So let's cut 2 wings using the lines. There we go. Okay. And what I also like to do is just to trim off the little corner tips. This is optional. You don't really have to do this. Aesthetically, I kind of like a little bit of the rounded wingtips. If you can see that. Just doing a quick little cut. And at this point, you can choose, you know, what side do you want. You can do, you know, whatever combination if you have colored note cards as this. I'm going to go ahead and just fold this in half, and this is going to add some dihedral to our plane. I'll leave the yellow on top and fold both wings. All right, lay those down. Okay, now for the tail, that is 1/4 inch wide, which is one of these rules. And 1 inch long, which I can just use my little grid here in my cutting board. I can just free cut this one. All right. Okay. Oh, I think my measurement's not 1 inch long. Let's see here. Oh, it's 1.5 inches. That's right. So it's this one. Okay. Also, I'm just going to trim off the little corners here real quick. And fold this in half as well. All right. I'm going to put that aside. And this little remainder part is going to provide the support for the wing on top. So we need 2 supports, if you can see that. And this right here just gets cut in half. So it's 1 inch long. And we'll just use my rule right here and just cut it in half. Sorry, you can't see that. Okay. Now what I like to do on those supports, and this is very difficult to see, is I provide little flaps to glue this to. This is where my pliers come into play, and I'm just going to grab a little bit of the paper like this and just bend it down. And you'll see how it kind of creates a little bit of a flap. I do one direction, turn it over, and just kind of fold it over the other direction. So I have like a little Z pattern, right? And then I'm going to do the same for the other side. Give that a fold. Oops. Take this one and give this one a fold the other way. All right. Okay. All right. Now, it's the glue. We need to know where to glue these supports. And I go about a half of an inch in from the edge. So it's about right here. We just need a line on both sides of the wings. Right there. And I'm going to do it on the underside of the top wing. This will be the top. And also do a half an inch. Probably no real science to where the supports are. You probably could vary that if you wish. Okay, so the next part is gluing. I think I'll have my little pink side stick outside. So I'm gonna go this direction here. Okay, so I'll have it inside. Let's do it inside. All right, so the trick is you just want to get a little dab of glue on the little flap. And I just kind of rub the bulk of it off. Don't need a whole lot of glue. I really want this to dry. Now the edge of this right here is going to be right on the line. So I have to kind of carefully also use a toothpick here to kind of help push that down where I need it and hold it down for a little bit. You probably could use hot melt glue. I choose super glue or CA glue just for the sake of it's so much lighter. And it's really not too difficult to work with. And that starts to stick pretty quickly. So I'm going to do this on the other side. Now, the way I folded this, I'm going to reverse my fold, is based on the angle of my wing. So my flap kind of points down like that, and then as the top wing will set, the flap will, this flap will be pointing upward. So that's sort of how I kind of align those. Get a little bit more glue on this one, and try to get it positioned. Got a little bit of play time before the glue sets. So if I need to slide it a little bit, I can get it in position. All right, it's a little crooked, but I can slide it maybe. All right, doesn't have to be exactly perfect. It will change sort of how your wing is angled though. That's all right. Okay, so the second part, or the second wing, is to get this glued right up there. I'm going to add some glue on this flap. A little pat. Wipe off the bulk of it. And now I'm going to keep both of these wings flat so that they're all nice and straight. And I'm going to push this into place and kind of hold it. Now you don't want to have a lot of glue on this because if you do, it just takes longer to dry and it slips on you. So you just wanna, and I know you can't quite see that, just wanna get enough to be kinda tacky. within a couple of seconds of actually holding it. Okay? So I have that in place. All right, so I need to get glue on this one. So here's an easy little trick. I just slide it in here like this. All right, let's try that. And also, same thing, just line it up. And just give it a push until it sets. Give it a couple seconds. And there we go. Okay. So we got our wings. Now I'm not adding any camber on the wings. These fly all right without it. Plus it's a little difficult to get a little camber on these wings. Okay. Now the fuselage, I've got a whole bunch of toothpicks here. I find the best toothpicks, a little bit more dense and heavy they are, the better. But interestingly, this variety of toothpicks, there's different, some of these are just heavier. Sometimes I can kind of hit them on a piece of, on the table, and I can, if it sounds a little bit more solid, I can, this one sounds pretty good. Normally these green ones, I don't know why, but let's go with this one. All right. Okay, positioning of the wing, as you can see, it's pretty far back. It's better balanced this way, it flies a lot better. The back leading, or the back trailing edge of the wing is 3/4 of an inch from the tip. So I'm gonna just put a line 3/4 of an inch in, about right there. And I'm gonna give it some glue on the bottom side of my stick. It's about a 1/2 inch or so. And at this point, you can probably choose what side you want as the front based on how well your wings might be angled, perhaps. All right, so I'm just trying to set this right in the center part where it's bent, it's folded. And also looking at it from the top, I'm trying to make certain it's straight. Like that. All right, gluing the tail on is pretty easy. Just get some glue on the tip of the toothpick, and this just sets right up there. Here you can just try to kind of keep it as straight as possible. I'm trying to align the tail with the wing. If you don't get it perfect, that's all right, because this is bendable. You can adjust it. There we go. And based on the angle here, it actually provides a little up elevator. Something also was noted in these toothpick gliders, kudos to FliteTest, who actually showed how to build toothpick gliders. And also shout out to GrandadIsAnOldMan, who probably, I think a couple years ago, he showed a very small paper airplane. May have been a toothpick airplane. If I find those links, I will provide them in the description. So here we go. All we need is a little bit of ballast. This is where a little bit of clay or blue tack comes in. FliteTest, he used his hot melt glue for a little weight on the nose. I'm just gonna rub it on there. This has a tendency to not stick so well sometimes. And there we go. Maybe adjust the tail out a little bit. And that's it. We got a toothpick biplane glider. All right, well, thanks. Enjoy life, enjoy flight. Keep on building. Take care, guys. That one wants to turn left. Let's try that again. Yep, a little bit of left turn. Probably can straighten it out a little bit. I'm going to give a little bit of curve up right there, hopefully. The air will help push that down a bit. There we go. That went a little right that time. maybe just a little too much. Take a little bit of that out. All right. There we go. Pretty good.